Hey everybody! Welcome back to Northern Land Plays. The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Always a little nervous. Let's pull the band-aid off as we go for 61 here as Eden. And we have a decent amount of HP. Cat of Nine Tails, I think? No, that's a Wooden Spoon. FF81ZT12. We have the Boomerang, Wooden Spoon. A lot of those stats are at the level 2, which is pretty okay. The size of our tiers seems really indicative of them not doing very much damage, which I know sounds ridiculous. But I like starting with the Boomerang because it gives me an opportunity to talk about my favorite topic, and that's that the Boomerang is totally freaking overrated, in my opinion. Northern Lion... I hate doing this voice because it's just the ultimate straw man tact. But anyway, Northern Lion, you know, the Boomerang does twice as much damage as your normal tier. This is correct. However, it also has a refractory period associated with it that is longer than I would like. So I feel like you could actually fire like two or even three tiers. If it's two tiers, it's still bad because you could just have another spacebar item in that slot instead, probably. The freeze does tip it a little bit, but I really feel like it's kind of the wrong play to even use the Boomerang, except for the freeze. By the time the freeze is over, you're shooting again, and I guess you've done free damage, but overall, I think it's a little overrated, considering the amount of time you're unable to fire. I will say, you know, our damage is not... our damage is not good, but our rate of fire is actually above average, I think, which is pretty excellent for where we are in the game. Kind of hoping that would be Small Rock, but one Spirit Heart, there's nothing to sneeze at there. And the fact that we got some extra HP out of it is great as well. I mean, as Eden, I don't want to toot my own horn, because that's how we're going to end up losing. Inevitably, if I brag a little bit on every run, I'm going to die on a run where I've bragged, and that's just the kind of, you know, poetic justice that I will not abide. However, it's pretty unlikely that we let's put it this way. The greatest chance for us to lose an Eden run is going to happen if we have low HP to start with. So I'm not that nervous about the fact that we have, like, high HP right now. Or based on the fact that we have high HP right now. I fucked this one up. Oh my god, I somehow didn't get hit there. That's okay. I'm gonna try to kite Mr. Bomb Dude. Get him to explode near the Tinted Rock. It whiffed on that one pretty hard. That's all. Oh, shit. Okay, it's okay. It's okay, we're gonna do a quick loop. That actually worked. Could have used the Boomerang for it, I guess. And I keep hitting the wrong thing with the Boomerang. I will say that my Boomerang argument is somewhat fallacious, considering that I pick up Eve's Mascara all the time, most of the time at least, which is pretty much the exact same philosophy. You fire less, but the shots do more damage. So where is my logic now? Oh, that's a really bad pill. That's a good point. Yeah, I can't deny that you're right about that. I might be an idiot. However, just because I'm an idiot, you know, if I have two different opinions, one of them is probably right. Let's put it that way. Let's see if we can get a bomb and blow up our other Tinted Rock. We can, and there's no Spirit Heart available in here, so I think this is pretty good. And nothing would make me feel a little bit better about getting a health downgrade as getting some more Spirit Hearts right now. Sweet. That's only one, but it's okay. So we'll go fight our boss. No matter what boss it is, we're pretty unlikely to get totally screwed by it. As a result of the fact that we have such high HP. For some reason, I was thinking we had an orbital there, which is obviously not true. This is going to be real annoying, but we actually... You know, this is like newfound appreciation for the Boomerang, if I could actually hit enemies with it. If I can crowd control them, just a touch. Yep. Okay, this is going to hurt a little bit. Very, very poor dodging. Thank God we didn't have low HP on this start. I was thinking we should be able to crowd control them a little bit more easily than that, but it obviously didn't quite work out that way for me. And that's okay. We still got a lot of HP, you know? I think one of the important things, if I could teach you anything about Isaac, and that is debatable, but if I could teach you anything about Isaac, I want to teach you a little bit about morale, you know? It's not about Isaac, it's about life, man. Your mood is directly tied, and this is going to sound like some, you know, new age nonsense in my opinion, but your mood is tied to your performance, you know? It's better to put yourself, to let yourself be in the best mood possible in order so that you might be motivated and consistent. I'm glad we got Torn Photo here. That's why I'm able to play so much Isaac. First off, it's a great game. I'm not taking credit for making it. However, I play Isaac the way I want to play it. Keeps me in a good mood and has allowed me to keep up, you know, what I consider to be some fairly remarkable consistency when it comes to at least showing up and playing the game. It's like, you know, doing your homework or something like that. If you make doing your homework as fun as possible, you're going to be more motivated to do your homework. That morale plays a part in within the context of each Rebirth run as well, I think. You know, if you take two hits of damage that you shouldn't have taken, it's very easy. And sometimes I'll do this off camera if I'm playing, like, while I'm traveling or something. I'll be like, oh, I took damage I shouldn't have taken. I'm not even, like, invested in this run anymore. Oh, it sucks. Let's just restart it. That's not a good place to be in. You're enabling yourself to take more damage. There is some power to positive thinking. Keeping a good mood and motivating yourself as much as possible, believing that you have the ability to do it, gives you a slightly better chance of being able to do it, I think. So we're operating under the assumption, well, the guarantee that we will not be very poor dodging here on my part, but we did find the secret room. Operating under the assumption, the guarantee here that we will not be fighting the Haunt, obviously. That's really good news. We should have a very, very good chance of getting a deal with the devil. That's even better news, because if we can pick up something that ups our damage, we're in a very good spot. Although I will say our DPS is actually pretty good. Well, no bombs, but that's okay. Our DPS is actually pretty good. Mostly as a result of, I think, starting with a decent rate of fire, but then obviously also picking up Torn Photo, which is a great damage dealer in and of itself. Almost done with Pin here. Maybe would have preferred to fight Pin on the last floor, get Torn Photo, and then do better against the Haunt, but hey, we have no control over this. There's HP, and a genuine deal with the devil. Headless Baby is probably like a C-minus deal with the devil item, but there are worse. You know, if you think a C-minus is bad, you gotta take some time off from school, my friend. A C-minus is acceptable. That's still a pass, you know? If you got C-minuses in med school, you are still a doctor. Also, you know, different places grade on different curves, you know? Different scales. A C-minus in college, pretty good. C-minus in high school, depending on the course you're in, you know, you might need to put a little bit, you know, reinvest your time in it somewhat, you know. Why are you taking this course if you don't care about it? You should, you know, be motivated. Anyway, scissors. These are like both pretty bad. I went through it in my head and I was like, every question that my head asked was like, is this guillotine? And I was like, no, head, it's not guillotine. It's the scissors, the worst version of guillotine. And then it said, yeah, but like, you hit spacebar and then it like removes your head from your body, right? That sounds like guillotine. And I'm like, nah, man, I know. How I can understand how the confusion could arise here, but it's not guillotine. So I was confused momentarily. Looks like we will not be able to bomb our way into our shop, but at least getting into the secret room would be meaningful. And we haven't really improved ourselves all that much here, but we're not in a dire circumstance. You know, we have decent HP, a lot of spirit hearts backing us up. The scary thing is that spirit hearts are temporary. The other scary thing is that like all of our pills have sucked the big one. We've had a tears down and a health down. The good news is we will probably not take another tears down or a health down. But we're really going to be hoping for... It's slightly against odds, but it would be really nice if we got another deal with the devil on this floor and we're able to pull something out there. Most important thing to remember here, I really, really doubt we're going to end up losing enough HP to put us at risk of death. But for deal with the devil purposes, we should recall that we are at 2 HP. So we don't want to take deals that utilize 2 HP suboptimally. Like if there's a 2-hard deal, we should take the 1-hard deal first. And then the 2-hard deal. I'm almost thinking I should have gone with the scissors, because at least with the scissors, like, I wouldn't use it. That doesn't sound like the greatest compliment to give a spacebar item, but I'm like with the boomerang, I feel like it gives marginal use, but I'm still compelled to use it because it exists. Yeah, we'll try it. I'm still compelled to use it because it exists. But I kind of feel like using it costs me in some circumstances. So maybe I should just not use it. Anyway, I gotta focus a little bit on the game here, because it's actually a semi-realistic chance. That's a very useful nickel, hopefully. There's a semi-realistic chance that this could be a bit of a tough run for us. We've had our stats, unfortunately, negatively affected by pharmaceuticals, taking some bad pills. We're gonna need to compensate for that, and in some ways, I mean, we're still doing okay on DPS, but there's room to grow. Another good deal with the devil would mean a lot. One bomb there can help us out if we get a better... Oh, I got... I walked like a step too far and got freaking hit by the poop there. We should pay more attention to our spirit hearts as well, because it's possible that we could take a deal with the devil that we can afford, but kills us because we don't have any spirit hearts to keep us alive after we take it. So, that, I mean, I'm not trying to start any cautionary tales or anything like that, but it's the kind of thing that bears mentioning. Feeling like got a decent amount of, like, residual damage with Headless Baby and Boomerang capabilities here. I hate these champions, man. One bad shot can put us in a real dangerous situation. Yeah, this is fantastic. I'm having a really good time here. Are you kidding me? You're still not dead? Take forever with the order here. Very important. Just calm down. His dead body, well, what was left of it, so his, you know, soul, fired a bomb at us, or fired a bone at us, which I was not admittedly very pleased with. That's okay. I think I'm safe here. Very important that we just, you know, never take damage again until we get Brimstone, hopefully. I don't want 61 to be where it ends. I want nobody to remember 61. Hey, a luck upgrade doesn't hurt. I want people to be like, yeah, where were you when run 60 happened, you know? That was meaningful. Run 61? I don't remember that at all. He must have picked up some amazing items, and it was a really, really easy one for him. Now, I'm no fan of fighting Mega Fatty, but I will say that I actually like that we have, it was a very dangerous dodge. I like that we have, creep associated with it. So I'm not using the boomerang, because if I can get him to jump on the creep, and then I freeze him, he should take a little bit more damage. That was a lot of work for something that didn't really provide me with that much benefit in the end. But you gotta admit, the theory was there. So it's gonna be a long fight. It's been a while since we've had a situation like this where we've been really toe-to-toe against an enemy. That was me moving in the wrong direction and feeling pretty stupid about it. We've lost maybe 3 hearts on this floor. And admittedly, maybe 3 hearts is enough to make me feel somewhat dangerous here. This run is so dangerous, Eden so dangerous, Eden so HP. I'd really like to get some more on meat, maybe some breakfast, please, maybe some HP. Yeah, you just keep shooting your weird brimstone laser that turns into bullets, Monstro's Lung style. We win. We get toothpicks, no deal with the devil. Only a mild disappointment, because toothpicks is good, and maybe it's better for us to at least know where our HP is at before we commit to taking any deals with the devil, but we're not really improving ourselves too much here. The damage DPS is happening, but you know, it's 2 steps forward, 1 step back, which admittedly is still 1 step forward last time I checked. However, it's, you know, we have to take more than 1 step forward on average in order to beat the game. You know, it's an analogy you're taking a little too seriously and weirding me out, so just cool it, Sanchez, or you'll get a knuckle supper. We have no bombs. I still would like to try this, though. And now I'm, like, paranoid about taking pills. It's I Found Pills, which is the best pill we've had so far. That might be a slight exaggeration. Explosive diarrhea could be better, even though it did hurt us a little bit in that one situation. Come on, give me some bombs. There's so much we can do with them. For now, though, we'll be in the somewhat unenviable position of having our best damage dealer be Headless Baby. That's very scary. Especially if we're dealing with flying enemies, it's pretty terrible. However, we can still make this work. That's real bad. That is not damage I should have taken. We gotta blow this up. Oh my god, 2 cents is not really what I was hoping to get out of that. There is some positivity to take from this. We got a black heart. No, what am I talking about? We got, when we got hit, we lost a black heart. That might sound bad, but I actually think it's pretty solid. We can also get an arcade on the next level. That might sound bad, but I actually think it's pretty solid because it means that we still have red hearts and we might still have some black heart protection as well. I am gonna get the black heart here. Admittedly, we could have used Book of Secrets twice with this. Like, use the bomb in that situation where we would get a battery and a bomb back, and then use it again and maybe find the secret room. But I'm content to just treat this as a more simplistic situation. Grab the black card. Our HP is not so bad. And then we'll use it on this floor and we'll hopefully string together a decent kind of mapping. So this is... It's probably not a stretch to say that our chances in this run hinge pretty largely on what happens on this floor. And largely that's going to hinge on at least getting a deal with the devil. I don't want to put too much pressure on the deal with the devil actually being good, because we don't really have control over that, you know? That's an RNG decision. If we can at least get a good... or get a deal with the devil, which should be not guaranteed, but pretty close to it, then life's good, you know? We got good chances for the future. If not, this could be a slow descent here into alcoholism and death. What can you drop? I fight you so rarely. Is it Bob's Curse? Well, I mean, a tarot card was assumed, but maybe Bob's Curse as well, which would have been awesome. I could really use the bombs. This is slipping a little bit. Let's just, I gotta take a second and give myself that pep talk about morale. This isn't, we've been in worse situations than this. All we need to do is kind of keep it together. I don't want to lose an Eden run that is not like 1 HP and then fighting the Haunt. That's just, that's not how I want to go. We're gonna have to use every advantage at our disposal to give ourselves the best possible chance, which sounds dramatic, but is actually just a, you know, a truism, I suppose. We do want to go to the curse room, but that's one of those things I'm gonna... Oh my god, are you kidding me with the movement and the knockback? It's one of those things we're gonna hold off on, temporarily, in order to save our spirit hearts, basically. Maybe save our run. Yo, normally I'm the guy who's complaining about a lack of keys. However, you have my permission on this run as of right now. Kind of some hairy dodges in there. You have my permission to... just give me a bomb instead of a key once, you know? Or give me a fuck ton of golden chests. You know, something along these lines would help me out a great deal. That mapping, I don't think it helped out, but it might have showed us the second secret room. This room is nerve-wracking. I'm bad at this room. But the good news is that it gets easier every day. Every single one of these enemies that we take out comes simpler and simpler. Less moving parts. It's good. Just get yourself in a safe place. This is not a situation on many, like on many, blah blah. This is not a situation as on many of my runs where I'm like, hey, we need to finish this room quickly. This is a room where I will be content to take my time. As long as we don't take damage, that's the only thing that matters. Oh, come on. Also, have fucking mercy. Thank you. We gotta go. Gotta go. Pretty lucky. Gotta go again. I think we're gonna make it. Well, that was not scary at all. I was not scared. Now, if we get hit on this room, which is actually, like, I'm not blaming the game. I'm blaming myself for a lot of the damage we've taken. However, there is something to be said about the fact that our shots do no damage and have a fuck ton of knockback. Oh, bombs. Who would have thought? No doubt, with two bombs, I'm gonna be buying a spirit heart here, unless there's, like, a blue candle or something. There is no spirit heart for sale, which, if you'll allow me to say, is really fucking fucked up. Apologize for my language there. We at least got the opportunity to pick up a decent amount of money. I did not mean to buy this bad trip pill, but in a weird way, it may save my life. Let's find... well, let's shoot the poop, man. This is getting to the point where I'm actually quite nervous. We can get away with not getting a deal with the devil on this floor if we have to talk about contingencies. It's possible, you know? Don't get a deal with the devil on this floor, just live. I hate this room. Yep, there we go. We'll take full health. This is a very bad situation. And I got nothing to blame this on, really, but myself right now. In a weird... I have to win this run right now for the honor of that, like, renegade full health pill. Bad trip, I guess. That I never would have expected to work out for us. But did, in the strangest way possible. And it taught me, taught me a lot about myself and about the world that we live in. It's basically like the newest feel-good Hollywood blockbuster. If you're working in the adult film industry, you need your own term for blockbuster, and I suggest that maybe you use cockbuster. It could be like a Hollywood cockbuster. You ever think about that? Health down. This is good in a weird way. Three of these same pills. You gotta be kidding me, though. Let's give it a try. Here we go. No fear. Gertie's not so bad. Champion Gertie. Very tanky. Very tanky. No orbital to speed up our damage here, but also a pretty low chance of us taking damage. If we don't take red heart damage on the boss, we do still have somewhere in the vicinity of like, it'd be like a 30% chance times 3 over 4. So like a 22% chance of getting a deal with the devil here. I'm willing to try. We'll only be able to take one thing, but then we can get a health upgrade afterwards. So I probably should have taken a health uphill in here, but at the same time I was also like, you know, I didn't know what our situation was going to look like in here. I didn't know if maybe pheromones would have been awesome for the enemies that we were fighting, so I hedged my bets a little bit. We'll take the health down pill with us to the next floor for sure. We still have an item room on this floor, so you know, all is not lost. All is not lost. There's still plenty of game left here. I mean, this is only Caves 2. There's a lot of content left in this game if we let it. Hopefully we get a chance at an arcade on this floor as well. A blood bag could help out a lot. Pageant Boy is like super not what I needed. I guess you're not what I needed. Like, super not what I needed. We could also use, hilariously, a health down pill to get into our boss trap room. But we can also just use two bombs to do that, I guess. Alright, well, what do we do? There are red hearts available, right? Yeah, there's red hearts available for us, so I think we go into the curse room. If I die on that curse room by getting hit by some spiders, I'm going to be as salty as I have ever been in my life, I think. Let's check out our secret room first. No, because there might be a stone chest in our curse room. Alright, I'm feeling pretty intelligent right now. Bad trip. Tears down. Wow. That was like super not what I needed, man. I guess you're not what I needed. Okay, we need a lot of the help here. This is my slow descent into madness, as mentioned. There's always a chance, is what I'll say. How do we do this? Well, it's kind of risky to go to that big room without having HP, so rather than walk back for the HP, I'm just gonna pick up the full red heart, I think, on the shop. Is there a bomb? Yeah, I'll pick up the bomb as well, even though it's cost prohibitive. The Bible is almost looking like something I might want to purchase. An occasional ability to fly, giving me consumables, better survivability against some asshole enemies. Two keys here. Well, we're lucky we have a lot of keys, actually. Okay, you can just pause the game if you're interested. At least it didn't tank the frame rate. And thank God that this is not a trap room down. Like, there's space for me to move. It's not the easiest room to be mobile on, but it's doable. Please let me reroll the floor or redo the whole run. Okay, AAA battery trickle charge is pretty good. Book of Revelations is really, really good. We can start to build a run off this. Let's see what this is. Just a golden chest and some bombs. Oh, but we got fates. Okay. This is almost to the point where I can start feeling really good about things. We're not quite there, but I think we can pick up a few extra spirit hearts. There's like a battery available that I didn't touch. We can get into our boss trap room now by bombing our way in. And there's, you know, it's Lloyd Christmas in Dumb and Dumber right now, so you're saying there's a chance. There is a chance. I wouldn't necessarily go out of my way to say it's a great chance. Now, if you want to continue the good feeling parade, a lot of pills that are awesome, or just one single magic mushroom would help out a lot. Luck up is fine. Three health downgrades is just hilarious. And two tears. yeah, we'll open it. I'm glad we had so many keys, man. Alright, we still are lacking a lot on this run. But from the jaws of despair, we have salvaged hope. We haven't salvaged victory yet, but we've salvaged hope. And my run that is, you know, 10% terrible RPG. RPG? 10% terrible RNG, 90% me playing much worse than I would like to admit, is starting to maybe get saved a little bit here by that fate pickup. If you think getting a lucky fate pickup is getting carried, then you have unrealistic expectations, my friend, of what the average Isaac run entails. All we need to do, keep morale high. If we don't get hit, well, there's more than we need to do, but if we don't take red heart damage on our next floor, we have a 100% chance to get a deal with the devil, to the best of my knowledge. Those are good numbers. I'll take those odds. We don't need a lot of... Oh, that was dumb. We don't need a lot to make this work. Oh my god, don't squander it. This is being squandered now. This is being squandered. No, just cool it. My butt. I can't believe I got hit five times there. Okay. Some of the poorest plays I've made. But we still have fate. And we can go to our shop and buy a battery. We can purchase a battery. And we can get an early Book of Revelations. And let's be honest, we're gonna have to fight war. So it doesn't really matter if we wait to use Book of Revelations or if we use it right away. I can't believe I lost that Eternal Heart, man. I'm extremely disappointed in myself. You can be disappointed in me too, but I am extremely disappointed in myself. But if you look at it on an absolute level, we have Book of Revelations, we have AAA battery. We're not too far away from relative comfort. Now, we are in Curse of Darkness Necropolis. That's going to be annoying. Not necessarily too heinous, but annoying at the very least. If we can just go, 10 rooms without taking a little bit of damage, I would be so grateful. And if we could just go 10 rooms without me making a terrible decision that cost me, a full health upgrade, that would be amazing. Man, that floor, if we had gotten a deal with the devil, actually could have been so good. There were, 10 health downgrade pills. If you're wondering, I'm assuming that most people know this by now, but health downgrade pills turn into health upgrades when you only have 1 HP left, so as to, mechanically make it so you can't accidentally kill yourself with one, or leave yourself at 0 HP, whatever that would mean for the game. So, it's a good thing. Health down pills are generally a good thing. If you take one accidentally, odds are you'll probably be able to find one later and use it to get that health back. So, it's like a delayed neutral. That's alright, Poison Touch is okay, and I'll never turn up my nose at the consumables. Let's throw down a bomb here in the hopes of finding a Spirit Heart. We did not find one. See that shadow drift across the floor on the right side of the screen there? That was freaking me out a little bit. Okay, that's dumb. That was bad damage on my part. And this is, I'm getting some old vanilla Isaac feelings where I'm like, I gotta shoot it in a bomb! That's never a good sign. If you have to shoot in a bomb, something on your run has gone terribly wrong. Or you have great bombs. So another thing we should definitely not do is accidentally leave this room. Come on, item room. I'm relying on you here. I'm starting to... Hope is wavering somewhat, but I believe in you. Oh, that is super not what I need. That's okay. That's okay. It's all about the D with the D, the bang dicky here. Now this is our, fucking Curse of Darkness, man. I can't see the flies. This is our, Book of Revelations charge right here, right? I'm gonna get hit. No. No, I'm not gonna get hit. It's morale, man. There we go. There we go. Great stuff. Get Book of Revelations back. This is it. You're gonna get 9 lives Brimstone here. You're definitely not gonna fight Krampus and get Krampus's head, I'll tell you that much. 100%. 100% that is a 0% chance to happen. What'll be really interesting is if a shop shows up and gives me, Blue Candle. Because I feel like that's borderline necessary for my survival and sanity. A blue or red candle. But also, we would lose our only hope at creating our own Spirit Hearts. An ideal shop would be a Nun's Habit, 9 volts, not really the battery, but you know, we'll cross that bridge when it comes. Do we want to fight a double boss now, or do we want to do a few more rooms trying to get some Spirit Hearts? I'm gonna do a few more rooms to try to give ourselves a better cushion, and I think we got lucky that one of those rooms is the shop. could give us a few outs here. Bombs are nice. It's greed, so we got nothing on this shop, theoretically at least. Except maybe greater purchasing power for the future. That's important, you know? With inflation, you want to make sure your assets appreciate at like 3% a year, otherwise you're just losing money to the national bank, so... Got one more room to get one more Spirit Heart. I was thinking, like, this is going to be so good because we'll get another Spirit Heart, we'll buy another Spirit Heart, and then we'll buy a battery, and we'll get even one more Spirit Heart. This clearly did not work out quite the way that I had intended. Hoping those skulls paid out a little bit more than they did. I'm a little nervous about, like, what the double boss fight can be here. But we do have, like, a 100% chance for a deal with the devil if we don't get hit. Bad bomb. Bad bomb, bad bomb. Oh, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when you place it really badly? Bad bomb. Yo, I basically can't see what's happening on my screen right now, so I'm very happy that that bomb appears to have landed based on the visual language that I was able to interpret. Similarly, if I lose this, I deserve to lose this run. Like, if I get hit more. Thank God we had bombs, man. This is a... Is my brain getting the best of me right now? Like, am I enabling myself to fail by not... By thinking that this is tougher than it actually is? Because it's looking fairly tough. When it looks like something at all, I can barely see what the heck's happening here. They issue, like, some kind of hotfix that made it so Curse of the Blind can't be countered... Or Curse of Darkness can't be countered by better gamma settings. We got a screw. Not... ideal, but doable. Wow. This is an extreme disappointment. Okay, so we have Mercy. We also did not get an orbital, but that might be a bad thing here. We gotta do a little bit more exploration, I think, to try to snag some more Spirit Hearts. It's always that value proposition. Is it better to get more Spirit Hearts? Or are you going to gain more Spirit Hearts than you lose by doing more rooms? I think the answer with AAA battery is probably more likely to be yes, even though I have been taking some terrible damage. And you never know, you know, there's stuff like cursed rooms and secret rooms and second secret rooms that we get enough consumables we can take advantage of. Especially since we have Fate, so we've really got to, you know, spare no expense here. Please be our secret room. I dislike you a little bit right now. Where are you, Brimstone? Why can't I find you? Why have you gone away? My run is sagging. My speech is nagging. Does that mean Brimstone's nagging? Oh, I didn't mean to place that, but... not a totally unhappy accident. So you'll know from... Hi, I'm Northern Lion. You may remember me from such comments as, this is my favorite room to also hate. And, man, how did I take that damage? So, basically that was what I meant to say there, but I put it in Troy McClure's voice to make it a little bit more palatable. I oftentimes take damage on this room, so I'm taking it super low, super slow, low and slow. I'm sous-viding this room right now. To make sure that we don't, you know, get fucked, basically. There's still a- Oh, I didn't even see you over there, dog! You're doing some sneaky shit. Good news is we can kind of abuse these choke points with Headless Baby, but... There we go. 1.5 Spirit Hearts. I will go into our cursed room with 1.5 Spirit Hearts. Alright. Okay, I'm not loving this right now. This is a little sad. 2 of clubs. I'm gonna pop it, man. Get it out of the rotation. Okay, let's go to our curse room. It's half a spirit heart. We got contract from below. Normally, I would be very excited by this turn of events. And I'm still happy about it. Don't get me wrong. I'm happy we got contract from below. But I could be happier. Oh, that's not it. Okay. What do we got in here? One of these. I'll try it. 1 key. Unlikely, maybe, to be super good. But unlikely doesn't mean guaranteed to be bad. I can't believe that we continue to leave, like, every floor with just the most minor, nearly most imperceptiblest... I don't think that that's actually a word. Most imperceptiblest of upgrades. It's amazing to me that we continue to just slowly, slowly fall behind the quality of our competition. Let's try to, you know, we got Goathead now, so hopefully it's not too little too late. We can get ourselves out of that bucket of syrup we found ourselves wedged in. This should be our secret room. I think it is worth looking maybe on our map for a second secret room possibility. Nope. I've decided that in actuality it is not. Let's head down to the next floor. This is basically our last chance to be comfortable. It's not our last chance to win, but it's our last chance to feel comfortable. What do I mean by that? Well, if we don't get super strong on this floor... Wow, that was very dangerous. If we don't get super strong on this floor, we're down to the womb. Three hits could kill us. If we get super strong on this floor, all's forgiven. You know, you put me through the ringer. But we're still here. We're still ticking. We're still kicking. We're still chicken. But if we don't get something on this floor, even if there's a brimstone located in this seed deep within the pockets of the womb... We may be unable to access it because every enemy is gonna, you know, BF us into oblivion. And I do not mean boyfriend. That was not very good damage. But we're only one room away from getting another Spirit Heart to back us up here. I've given up all hope about stacking Spirit Hearts, apparently. We're at, like, a very unsteady equilibrium. Double key room. I like it. But could you have given me, like, a guppy item? Another health downgrade pill is, at this point, I can't do anything but laugh at these health downgrade pills. If there's a PhD in our shop, you know, I'm assuming those become full health, not balls of steel. Or sorry, I'm assuming they become health up, not full health. That's what I meant to say there. Even if they become balls of steel, that's pretty good. Well, you know, while we're here, let's try this. That's probably pretty nice. Oh, come the fuck on. You're gonna give me cursed eye here? That's what's fucked up about it, is that I'm also debating it. I'm like, man, would cursed eye give us the power we need here? I don't want to take it. I think it's probably in our best interest not to take it here. And I'm the guy who's always taking cursed eye and, you know, giving the D100 a fair shake. This is one of the few runs where I would actually, you know, be taking a potentially lost run and turning it into a one run. Maybe, by getting a reroll room, but they appear to not be showing up now, which is lovely. Very convenient for them. But, Cursed Eye has a genuine chance to actually ruin our shit here. Don't get me wrong, I love charge shots. I think it's just, the risk is just too great right now. Thank God for our incredible knockback. This is the first time I've said that over the course of this run, but it actually did help us kill that room more easily than I would have otherwise expected. This is definitely a... bombable situation. Oh, good! Yo, I can't help but point out, the only positive pills we've had have been luck upgrades. Do you feel lucky, punk? Do you? Every skull we've blown up has had a host in it, basically. We're about to take red heart damage. It doesn't really matter that much, but... You know, we do have the goat head now. However, if possible, I would still prefer to stack up some spirit hearts, you know. We might be in for the long haul on the mom fight, so... Oh, Jesus. To have some spirit hearts would not be the worst thing in the world. This is where I'm hoping Headless Baby comes through for us. It's still, like, our best item, which is sad. And I'll take some ownership for a lot of the problems on this run. Losing that Eternal Heart was very devastating for me. At the same time, I have to feel that, like, one Eternal Heart is probably not that much of a difference maker on a run like this. Maybe, though, on that floor, losing the deal with the devil might have put us in a position that's tough to come out of. Oh my god, two runes. One of them could be a per throw, allowing me to reroll. The cursed eye. And a Yera rune. A Yera rune normally would be a guaranteed use on the chest in order to get more items. We could still do that, don't get me wrong. But we may also want to just use it to get as many fucking black cards as possible. We'll take a look and we'll see if maybe there's a, if there's more Yara runes. Oh my god, this is so good. Keep blowing it up, man. We'll even blow this one up, even though there's only one to be had here. Alright, next step. All the shit that... Oh, I shouldn't have picked that up. All the shit that you don't want, or you can use right away. Chariot is amongst them. Hermit is amongst them. Hankman is irrelevant. Stars is largely irrelevant. Justice card is pretty good. Alright, what about our other runes? We got a Purthrow over here. I got honeys on my left, fellas on my right. We got four Yara runes. I gotta try, right? Like, does it double the Yara runes in the ground? No, but it does double the Purthrow runes. And we know we can only take one Yara rune unless we get starter deck. So why don't we just keep doubling our Purthrow runes to give us more rerolls in here? Purthrow, Purthrow, Yara, Purthrow, Purthrow. We got five rerolls, many, many Chariot cards and Hermit cards. What's our pills are health down, hilariously enough. Let's Hermit a little bit. A little less conversation, a little more Hermit. Only thing that rhymes with that, we would have to be Kermit's. Surprisingly hard to make a parody when you don't understand the song you're gonna sing. A little less Hibbidoo, a little more Kermit. That sort of worked. So this is big. The Yara rune is a fan favorite. This may be one of the only situations in which it is better to not take the Yara rune in favor of taking a fucking Purthrow rune, so that we can reroll one of the few remaining deals with the devil into something that is hopefully a run winner in and of itself. Now, there is the chance that this could end up biting me in the ass. Most of the time you take the Yara rune, it's kind of for comic effect. You're like, oh, I get double the items on the chest, but I'm already gonna win. That's just, you know, most of the situations are like that. This is not necessarily one of those situations, though. This is a situation where it might be prudent to carry more rerolls, or a reroll. Can't believe I didn't get hit there. In order to basically give you a chance at rerolling fucking Ghost Baby into Mom's Knife. And you know, there's something to be said for that. I really wish that I had not picked up that black card. Did I pick up both black cards before using the Yara runes? Like, we could have had, like, eight black cards, which would have been... I haven't talked about it, but that is a fairly terrible mistake. Leaving eight black cards behind is definitely a lot worse than one Eternal Heart, I think. This late in the game, especially. But I'm not gonna dwell on it, because there is still... There's a win embedded deep within the loss of this run. We're going to reroll, like, the reason that I'm coming back here without taking Rainbow Baby, of course, is that I'm going to reroll the shit out of Rainbow Baby. Because it's decent, but not nearly good enough to take when we need a fucking Hail Mary. And I may end up taking nothing as a result of rerolling it, but I think taking nothing is better. Well, it's not better than taking Rainbow Baby, you know what I mean. The risk of taking nothing is worth the potential reward of getting something that's at least a little bit more meaningful. That room, I really can't recall a skull room like that working out as well as that one did. Lemon Party is also pretty okay, but we're not really gonna get much of a chance to use it. Okay! Wow, what a hilarious situation we find ourselves in here. This is an easy one! We'll take our Purthrow rune. We will march it up to that secret room where there are items such as Raw Liver, Black Lotus. Of course, let's not forget about the most important one of all. The sack of pennies. This is why I'm going for the secret room pool first, because the secret room pool is substantially better. Now we gotta... you know what? It doesn't really matter if we use our last Purthrow rune, because then our decision is made for us. We'll take Yarrow with us, but... Shielded Tears. I mean, in a way, I almost feel like I have to, because it's pretty good. And our rate of fire is pretty good. So you know what? Shielded Tears is better than Rainbow Baby. So let's go now and reroll Rainbow Baby. And then if we reroll Rainbow Baby into something that isn't shit, maybe we'll reroll Shielded Tears. Shielded Tears is not a win, probably, but it contributes, it helps out. Man, I'm a little on edge here. Hello, ghost baby.
Hello, ghost babe, my old friend. I've come to reroll you again. Because your qualities are stinky. And my run's bad, so I'm picky. And the streak that hangs in the balance of the run is pretty fun. So fuck yourself, ghost baby.
Man, it's like not the coup that I needed here, but I will admit we're firing real quick. I can't believe, by the way, both of our last shops here had ended up having greed in them when I could have used anything. But this is our last per throw, then we take the Yara rune with us. 10 bombs. In a weird way, that's substantially better, because I need it. Okay, well, we know we've got to deal with the devil here. If there's no XL floor, we got to deal with the devil on the next floor. I'm almost tempted to take a health downgrade pill instead of the guppy, or instead of the Yara rune with us. What is it? It's like chariot, fucking health down, hermit. And then, what's this one? Lament Party. Chariot? Okay, well, I mean, we could use... We could go through the laborious process of taking our Lament Party pill to the room, using it, then walking back. But I'm not going to do that. Instead, I'm going to use, like, half of our haul, 40% of our haul, to do this. And, you know, we got a Temperance card out of it, which is actually potentially really good. So let's not, you know, look a gift horse in the mouth on this one just yet. And then it gave us IV bag, so go fuck yourself. If that had given me a blood bag, I would have a new lease on life right now. I'd be picking up good vibrations. She'd be giving me excitations. Excitation. She'd be giving me good vibe. I'm not gonna continue, but I'm like really in a scary place right now. And don't give me this bullshit, oh, you fucked up the eternal heart. Blah, 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 blah. It wouldn't make a big difference right now. We're not. You know, it's like saying, hey, Bill Gates, you freaking, you know, your business wouldn't have failed if you're, hey, let's do this way. Hey, Enron, you know, I know why your business failed. You bought paper clips? You bought paper clips from an inopportune supplier. They were inefficient. They charged you too high of a unit cost. You know, they had bigger fish to fry. You're not necessarily wrong. You just aren't unreasonably choosing the wrong kind of business practice to be concerned with. I love that we have Book of Revelations and have still yet to pick up a single orbital as well. Because it's not like a cube of meat would completely change my life on this mom fight or anything like that. It's not like that would be really, really freaking good. This is all about stopping the bleeding as much as possible now. Thank you. It's all about just not taking much damage, really. I mean, sounds overly simplistic, but That's the draw, man. We have a little bit of HP that has to last us probably a long time. I feel like this is how the average Isaac run is meant to go. By design. And that scares the shit out of me. Okay, that was terrible damage. Let's just call it like we see it. Let's not take any more. Normally, by this point, you have a pretty good indication of how the run's going to go. Maybe we do have a good indication of how this run's going to go right now. I just don't want to talk about it. Maybe it looks like this run's going to lose, but I don't want to face the fact that for the first time in a month, we're going to be possibly out on our ass with a loss. This is now probably officially the hardest position we've been in over the course of the streak. I am very displeased with that. There's our deal with the devil. Not fucking Krampus, please. Oh, you cocksucker! Oh, you dick, you absolute consummate asshole. Great use of the bombs I got from that item room. Thank God we didn't end up picking up Rainbow Baby. That would be really disappointing. Who needs the gish effect sometimes? Not me. So, this is real bad because we really, really cannot afford to use bombs on every single room. They're vanilla bombs, too. Thank God we got a lump of coal, at least. Oh, shit, guys. This is terrible. is what this is. Gray skies are gonna clear. Oh, curse of the blind, really? Put on a happy face. We're rolling back prices all over the place, so put on a happy face. Well, how do we get out of this one? That's quite simple. Quite simple. So simple, I'll explain it in due time. Well, let's go through the basics. We survive this floor. That guarantees us a deal with the devil. Our deal with the devil provides us with a run-winning item. As a result of this run-winning item, we win the run. There's option one. Option two. Our deal with the devil sucks. We do absolutely everything in our power to get to the chest. That's not gonna be easy. Slowly. Yeah, I just, like, we're getting backed into a huge hole here. But if we can get to the chest, then there's a big out for us because we have this Yara rune. I personally don't see us getting to the chest without some kind of pretty enormous boon here. I should give credit where credit is due on this run. Thank God we picked up Book of Revelations. Were it not for that, we would be screwed. Thank God for a AAA battery, which has also helped us out a great deal. Thank God for Goathead, which gives us a greater glimmer of hope than we would otherwise have had. Thank God for this Yara rune, which in an unlikely circumstance, but a circumstance that is literally possible, could give us a much better chance of pulling out of this run without extreme shame and failure. We could play this once and maybe like try to get a blood bag and, you know, blow up some stuff, try to get blood banks out of it. I don't think it's too likely. Try to get blood banks out of it? What are you talking about? You know what I mean! You know what I mean. Blow up the... What I meant is blow up the polyps. Hey! Finally. Blow up the polyps and try to get hearts out of them. There's also a potential run reroll here. I would take it, man. Five allows us to do the floor over again. That's actually an extraordinary boon for us right now. That is a huge potential. Especially if we don't get an XL floor on the reroll. If we get an XL floor on the reroll, it's meaningless. But this allows us to get one more deal with the devil, and those are precious fucking cargo right now. Worth their weight in everything, no matter what, any kind of precious metal. Scandium! Doesn't matter. Also, if we can pick up that HP upgrade pill, and then get an HP upgrade from this double gluttony fight, I will believe that there is someone out there in the universe who had tested us, and is now saying, you know what, he's passed the test, okay, well go fuck yourself, universal piece of... Go do it. Just do it. Okay. What's the most important thing here? What's for breakfast at Cozy? The most important thing here is take as few... I really thought that would be our secret room. Take as few hits as possible so that you have enough spirit arts to survive if you end up trading a lot of your HP away on this deal with the devil. Then we go back to the 5 room, reroll the shit out of the run, and do it all over again. So having some extra spirit arts to back us up would not be bad. Also, if we get to have a boss fight... Oh, it's probably going to be death, huh? Conquest. Even better, so we'll get nothing out of it. I don't really know what I expected at this point. Conquest is a pain in the ass. I may be a little quiet here. I can't believe we're at 53 minutes, we're on room 1, and I'm going to do the floor. I'm going to do it over again. I'm all out of love. I'm so lost without you. Brimstone, I knew you were good. Picked you up in so much. Please show up again. I really could use you. People say you don't give any damage ups, but your killing potential is off the wall. I can't believe we may get through this without getting hit. I'm waiting for him to do the surprise attack and take us out. Okay, obviously that's going to be the white pony. Well, we have to, so we're going to, as you might expect. Razor blade. Mom's knife. That's pretty good. So, now we have Mom's knife. This is a way out of the situation that we found ourselves in. Holy shit, I've got a new lease on life. Do not do not throw this away. Oh my god, there's a tinted rock. Do not throw this away. Just play it cool. We're going to explore as much as we can. We're going to get as many spirit hearts as we can, and we're not going to lose any spirit hearts in the process of gaining as many spirit hearts as we can. We're going to keep this streak going. I bet many people were probably like, oh, this streak is over. It's not necessarily continuing. But certainly, never want to take that vector there. But certainly, we're back, baby. Baby, come back. We'll try. Oh, it's an item. I'm telling y'all, it's a mirage. I'm telling y'all, it's a sabotage. That is a freaking two item payout. Oh my god. The carry is not even real. It's so carry, it's fucking Carrie Fisher. It's Cary Grant. It's Cary Movie 4. HP. I don't care about permanent Polaroid invincibility. I think we fucking got it. I'm losing my mind, but I think we got it. Speedball. It's okay. The speed is nice. Magic 8-Ball. Okay, and it's getting a little silly. Two of Spades. 28 keys. Well, still, we got certainly a lot faster. I should have been holding Book of Revelations when we finished that room, of course, but it's okay. I think we're going to do this. And yes, Mom's Knife carried us. And we fucking... I'm not going to say we earned it, but we certainly lived long enough. You know, if you lived to 90, you're not like, oh, look at this old shitbag getting his pension. Yo, he fought to preserve the freedom of this country, and you will pay respect. This hypothetical war, not just a war veteran, a war hero that I made up. Don't be hating. Okay, this is... We'll do it in steps. Step by step. Ooh, Edmund. I wanna push on your bones. 53 minutes. Nothing wrong with that. It's weird that it's 53 minutes, and when I look over at OBS, we're at like 57 minutes. Like, I don't think we've had 3 minutes of cutscenes or something like that. There's some weird... It's some contact shit. They should have sent the poet. Yes, yes, Northern Line. That is a quote from the movie Contact. Come on. Eternal Heart, come on. Oh, where are you... Where are you at? That ain't Falco, etc., etc. Five room, right? Don't leave, buddy. Someone in the comments, how much you want to bet he leaves that five room? Yo, go fuck yourself, dog. I'm that star up in the sky. I'm that mountain way up high. So glad I made it. Pretty much just the world's luckiest, but still, there's nothing wrong with that. I'm that little bit of hope when your back's against the wall. So glad I made it. I'm the world's greatest. This is good stuff, man. I have a chance, you know? It's crawl space. We've picked up a lot of HP, actually. And Mom's Knife. Let's not talk about the razor blade. We paid 3 hearts for Mom's Knife. That's a deal that I'll take in a desperate situation, you know? That's $100,000 for a 50% chance to win the Powerball lottery. That's a good deal if you can muster the starting funds. Now we have this Yara rune that we can rely on for the chest, probably. I can't believe that our bullshit deal with the devil actually worked for us. You are running very low on disk space on drive C. Did someone just try to send me a file on Skype? Who tried to send me a file on Skype? I'm recording a video right now. I have 0 bytes free on drive C. That actually seems like really bad. But it's not... OBS doesn't record on drive C unless it's like temp files. Don't end the video like this. I apologize for this. I didn't expect it to happen. Empty recycle bin. How many bits do I have left on drive C? Bits and bytes? 0 bytes left? That seems really bad. I really hope like my solid state drive is not breaking. But everything on my computer is looking a little framey right now. This would be a bad time for this to happen. Well, I just deleted, so there we go, we got 1.76 gigabytes left. If there's a temp file, this will at least take us to the end of that. I don't think we've ever had a temp file this large in OBS. OBS does not save on my solid-state drive, by the way. I mentioned something about computers, so I'm sure there's going to be people like, why would you record on your solid-state drive? It's got no space, it's inefficient. Yeah, okay, I know. I record on my other drive, but I think that OBS might natively save temp files on the C drive. I don't know, dog. Okay? It's okay. Let's not sweat it too much. We're all gonna be okay here. Still looking for tinted rocks. Still struggling to find them to some extent. I'm still taking longer than I'd like to kill an enemy of the caliber of Mr. Fred. But we still got some HP too. Might have wanted him to wait on that. You don't lose anything by waiting on that. So this is a fun one, isn't it? I think it is worth killing ourselves with Judas's Shadow. Is there any way that we can do this and like get more spirit hearts out of it in the end? No, because we don't respawn with it. So I think we take the mark and Judas's Shadow. I don't think we benefit really from leaving. We could have prior to this, but we're not going to now. Now, this is a very, very delicate operation, and I will acquiesce that it seems very fitting, shall we say, that were I to die, it would make sense to have Judas's Shadow be a part of it after I've praised it so much on this run. What I'm thinking is that we wait until we're sure that we're going to get a Book of Revelations charge. And that's going to happen on the next room. After we kill these guys, we will know that we have a Book of Revelations charge coming. We will bomb ourselves into oblivion, because we can't fall on the spikes. In the meantime, we might as well look for secret rooms along the way. Let's just... Oh, that's not what I meant to do there. Let's verify that we have Judas's Shadow. We got a times one there. It's going to take several bombs here. I don't think there's spikes or fires that I found. I'm not that worried about my bomb economy, to be honest with you. We'll respawn. You can tell my voice is quivering a little bit here. I'm actually a little nervous. We'll respawn with a huge amount of damage. And instead of seven spirit hearts, we'll have three. That's not that bad. That's not that bad. We'll explore as much as is humanly possible, not just for tinted rocks, but the possibility of getting an HP downgrade pill or a health upgrade pill. Both of them exist in the rotation. Secret rooms, more spirit hearts just through killing enemies. Like, these are all very, very, very important right now. So, we have to remember, I've already killed my ability to respawn here, so I can't rely on coming back with Judas's Shadow. So what we really, that was close, what we really, really need to avoid is dumb damage. And we've been saying that the whole run. I probably sound like a broken record, but it never has stopped being true. There are some times where I'm like, I took a little bit of dumb damage, who cares, it's not going to affect the run. It will affect the run in a considerable fashion here. That is a huge pickup for us. Oh my god, I'm easing, like I'm a sigh of relief is slipping out here. I'm feeling good. And I think we are going to pull out a win here. Heck of a way to do it, I'll tell you that much, but I think that we did it. And this is a run where I would imagine that you'd probably think that I succeeded in spite of myself, and we haven't won it yet, but if we win, I think people are going to be like, you probably deserve to lose that one, and you're not wrong at all. But you win some you shouldn't win, and you probably lose some you shouldn't lose, so, you know, I'm not going to say it all comes out in the wash, but I'm just happy. I've got a big smile on my face. Unfortunately, I probably will not have time to shave prior to the NLSS, and that is going to make me look pretty grody. But that's okay, because I don't have to leave my house. Oh, man. This was not good. This was a wake-up call. But I'm actually... I can't even stress how surprised I am that we're going to come out of this one. We should check that arcade, because we can play Judgment. And I got a little ahead of myself. I forgot we're not on... the cathedral, because we've done the womb 2 twice. So we still need to be vigilant a little longer, at least, till this judgment is fine. I actually might not want HP at this point, but if he gives me some kind of mapping, that's awesome. The Judas' Shadow pickup and the Mom's Knife pickup, both so, so critical on this run. Yo, I really, really do not want your red hearts right now. And the Fate pickup. By itself, not that important, but with Mom's Knife, even on low HP, gives me a really good... ability to come out of this. Please, please, my friend. That's not what I want. But I appreciate that you paid out at least. You know, it's not my fault I'm going to the health store and going, oh, I don't want health, you know? That's what you pay out for the most part. You got side dishes in the form of the compass sometimes, but it's a rarity. It's not your default menu option, I'll accept. Now, we have not taken any guppy items, so I don't expect the curse room to be a huge... Don't expect the curse room to be a huge boon for us, but if we can get into it for free, which we can, why not? That's a health up. That's I found pills. Health up was... It's better on the last floor because there was a guppy's paw pickup we could have taken. That doesn't mean it's bad to take now. But I think we're going to be able to top up at full health with spirit hearts. So I kind of feel like we're going to be able to... It's going to be better for us, I should say, to just be in this situation where we got a little bit more wiggle room with our spirit arts to go, and it'll only take like another 12 rooms or something like that for us to get there. But we could get to 3 extra red hearts, which is... It's tempting. It's tempting. We'll lose the permanent Polaroid invincibility, which is the big problem with it. And we can do a lot of damage with Mom's Knife permanent Polaroid invincibility, but... Small rock, maybe? Well... There you go. There's our HP cap, so feeling pretty okay about that. We do have Guppy's Tail now, so I'm thinking these keys are probably going to have a pretty decent opportunity to prove their merit to me. And we're going up to the cathedral looking a lot better than we looked, you know, 2.5 floors ago, however you want to describe the number of floors that we've done. Oh, come on. Well, this is our permanent Polaroid invincibility chance, though. You can see that it was pretty effective for us there. And we're only one room away from full health again. And we got a Yara rune for the chest. This run's been 5 years. That's all we've got. It's been 5 years. Okay, like seriously though, man, it is... You know when I've sung like one whole album's worth of songs. First off, you know that I'll be the next Canadian Idol winner. But secondly, you know that this is a long one. My brain has exhausted its relevant, you know, rock pool of commentary options. And we've just resorted to the lowest common denominator, which is pretty much where I exist on a regular basis. Look, allow me to exercise a lack of self-control. We're not going to need this many keys. I can leave some keys behind, Mom. God, I hate you. I'm glad you're dead. Well, that's like straight up the most... I felt bad after saying it. I was like, oh, Daddy Longlegs, don't feel bad, man. Might have been triacnid anyway. Triacnid, don't feel bad, man. Oh, this is so fast now. Oh, Jesus, I can't believe we're gonna pull this out. I probably, like, so do not deserve this win. She's the game, and it feels pretty good. She's the game, had some doubt that I would. That's alright, a little permano... Polaroido, Invincibilio, and Resquiata, and Impache, and all that jazz. Oh, it's so good, man. Yara rune. Don't forget to use that. We can at least go out on a strong note. Too bad we didn't know. Like, if we had known in advance that Blank Card was in there, that could have been good. I'm not going to take Odd Mushroom. The damage I don't think is worth the loss of Polaroid Invincibility. I'll take everything else except Blank Card. Oh man, it's so nice. Let's not throw. I don't think I'm gonna throw though. It'll be hard to throw this one. I don't know if Ipecac actually gives us a damage bonus. Regardless, you know, on our existing damage, we were doing fine anyway. Oh, one-shotting Mega Fatty. It's not fair to compare it because they were so far apart, but do you remember when it took me 100 years to kill Mega Fatty because he's got a lot of HP and I was not doing very much and I took a lot of damage in the process and I was feeling really bad about myself and I was about 85% sure that we were going to lose the streak, but instead we're going to 61? Like I said, I don't want anyone to remember run 61. Blank card. The tower. Well, that is like super not worth it. Didn't really want to kill you first. What's done is done, though. Full HP, especially considering we have the miter. The throw is not impossible, but very unlikely here. Kamikaze, leech. We should probably take the leech. Kamikaze is obviously terrible for us here. I forgot that we had Humbling Bundle, or Contract from Below, so we're actually gonna theoretically get a lot of chests here. It doesn't really burn me if they're not golden chests. Or if they are golden chests, for that matter, you know, we have the resources necessary to open whatever needs to be opened. Just your average 1 hour, 10 minute long Isaac run. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Sunny day, taking the clouds away. I'm on my way to Blue Baby B. Won't you tell me how to get to a triple digit streak? It's, you know, given the circumstances, I think you have to be relatively pleased with that parody, if you will. Everything's gonna die in one hit. Man, I had to use a drink after this one. Yeah, Virgo Spoonbender? This is my favorite character name for RPG character creators. There's an elegance in that joke that was lacking, but, you know, the theory of the joke is okay there. Oh man. Still kicking and sticking here. I mean, we're getting some great items here. Where were these items a little earlier in the game, if you'll allow me to complain at least ever so slightly? We could have used it, like, basically any one of these much, much earlier than we got them. Oh, that feels good. We're up to 61. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And, of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.